This week on Primo's Truth About Hunting.
We're here at Roseland hunting Sean Burke's place.
We didn't bring the bow, brought the 12 gauge.
Some deer are rutting right now, and it's the 7th of February.
Louisiana extended their season.
There was 2 months. He was massive. I don't know how many points he had, but he's got mass.
Louisiana hunting big palmetto flat.
Gnarly. Big old brute.
Love got that one whacked.
Kind of like crappie fishing. When you get a hot spot, drop all the jigs.
Truth About Hunting is brought to you by Bushnell, Polaris, Matthews, Savage Arms, Federal Ammunition, Rage, Squincher, Ozonics, Yeti Coolers, and Primo's Hunting. Speak the language.
Roseland Refuge, located right on the Mississippi River in the heart of the Louisiana Delta farmland. Roseland is owned by Sean Burks and his family. Sean and his son Spencer are in the old wood reclaiming business. Antique Woods of Louisiana uses old reclaimed wood to build some absolutely beautiful furniture, homes, and hunting lodges. From big cypress breaks to palmetto swamps and big hardwood river bottoms, Roseland could be mistaken for South Florida. Roseland has done a great job of improving the wildlife habitat by making big bedding thickets with thick cutovers connected to secret food plots within these big palmetto flats. And this habitat provides the cover and food to grow some big swamp donkeys.
We're here at Roseland hunting Sean Burke's place. It's kind of an odd time of year. We're not used to hunting this time of year. It's February the 5th. Louisiana extended their season for this part. If it's deer season, we're gonna be hunting somewhere. So Sean let us come down here. We got the whole crew. Should be a good week. Louisiana hunting big palmetto flats. Mississippi River bottom deer. You don't get much better than that. How those steaks look right there, Chris. Yesterday, Chris and I, dedicated bow hunters that we are, we caught up 3 bucks in the gun range, but not in the bow range. So today we're gonna level out the playing fields. I got a little old slug gun right here that I'm fixing to shoot and see. Probably gonna have it waiting on them today. Dead on them. That's what I'm talking about. Oh yeah. Keith said he wanted to come
leave
shoot.
Her there to shoot.
All right.
We're ready.
We're ready for this afternoon. Back in the same spot Chris and I hunted in yesterday. Except for we brought climbers in to adjust for the wind.
And we brought some firepower today. The wind swapped out of the north, so we backed up. Got on the south side. All the deer should be in front of us there. They're headed towards the Mississippi River. Big lady out there, green grass and stuff. These deer just funnel right through this big palmetto flat.
This segment of Truth About Hunting was brought to you by Mossy Oaks Native Nurseries, Mossy Oak Properties, and Gold Tip Arrow.
Leave it to Primo to make a call so simple, it's automatic. Introducing the Bombshell Automatic Turkey Call. Designed, tested, and perfected. To yell, cut, and purr. With a simple push or pull. Hold it or mount it. Just don't underestimate it. The Primo's Bombshell. Keep it simple. Speak the language.
Dang it. What? You gotta be kidding me.
With this bad boy right...
Cut.
Mike, what's up with the phone?
This is life or death.
What?
With the new Trophy Cam HD Wireless, the images are sent directly to your phone, tablet, or computer for up-to-the-minute scouting info wherever you go. It's the trail camera that comes to check you.
The leader in the evolution of lethal technology brings you the all-new Hypodermic, the most sleek, deadly, and accurate broadhead in the world. Rage's patented slipcam design carves its way through flesh as the hybrid tip and solid steel ferrule smash their way through bone. Be silent. Be lethal. Be surgical with the Hypodermic from Rage.
Dedication to innovation. One bow. The most accurate technology. One cam. When the reward is within range. One moment. A name you can rely on. One choice. Matthews.
It's February the 5th. We're hunting at Roseland with Sean Burks. And after yesterday afternoon, these deer are in a secondary rut. We caught up 3 shooters in here yesterday. February.
I say, we got him, buddy.
Oh, you scared.
I look back at you one time to make sure you had it.
Oh, yeah.
There's no way he don't have it. Hey, you see him look at us a couple of times?
Yeah.
I couldn't get turned around. I just waited. I think he's got a... He don't have
he's
a right eye.
He's a bruiser.
Yeah. He don't have a right eye.
I don't know. I'm glad you went ahead and shot him because I don't know if he'd have come on by.
I know. I shot the first chance I got.
He did.
That was fun, man.
Big old stud.
What a buck.
Look at that deer. There's the eye. I could tell when he walked up. That eye was put out. He's got scars all over his face. Man, that was a fun hunt. February 5th. That's an awesome way to end the season right there. Big, heavy Louisiana swamp donkey, baby.
This segment of Truth About Hunting was brought to you by Black Gold, Ripcord, and Tight Spot Quivers.
This is my rifle.
This is my rifle.
My rifle. There are others like it, but this one is mine.
This one is mine.
I must master it as I must master my life.
I must fire my rifle true.
With one shot, I must make one quick kill.
One clean kill.
One humane kill.
My rifle and I know is the hit that counts.
We will hit.
One shot, one kill.
The new standard in side-by-side utility. Now we're giving it company. They share the most torque, the smoothest suspensions, the best storage, class-leading comfort, and a revolutionary collection of versatile accessories. The 60-horsepower Ranger XP 900 and 5-passenger Ranger Crew 900. Together, they're a whole new class of hardest working, smoothest riding.
Everyone meets Spencer back at camp to show off Jordan's buck and relive the story.
See, we probably would have later.
I wouldn't say that.
Right? Heck no.
While they fire up the grill, just when the steaks are burning and smoking good, Mr. Celebrity himself finally shows up.
Is that not incredible?
Hey, it's just whenever you can get here, dude.
Yeah, just show up whenever. Come on, join the party.
Hey, I'm in the big boy.
Hey,
like, that's a killer's crib right there.
You look like King Jordan.
I am.
You get to sit there and kill a deer.
So you whack one today?
Yeah.
Bow, gun?
Yeah, gun.
28 yards?
No, 20.
That was 23.
22 yards. Slug gun.
Chris and I had
20-something yards.
We had to change stands because of the wind. So we backed off from where we've been hunting about 75 yards. All the trails are out there, 70 yards.
That's old school.
I'm Kevin.
This is my buddy.
Nice
boy.
Nice boy.
Yeah,
this is Hick right here.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
What y'all gonna eat? I'm like, I got mine.
It's pretty muggy this morning, overcast, foggy.
Chris said they coming. I got here late last night. Jordan killed a buck yesterday with his 12 gauge. So, what Chris didn't tell me is the tree stand I'm in doesn't have a seat. Chris, they didn't put a seat in it for some reason. It's one of them stand-up stands. Keeps you ready. Keeps you on your game. Yeah, right. He just went down right there. Did you see him fall?
Yeah.
Man, so fast. Hey, when I said you got him, you said, yeah. When he took a step, that was my best opportunity because I had this big tree. I'd had to come around this other side.
I wasn't going to stop him.
Were you on the right deer? There was two bucks.
I was on the close one.
Yeah, the close one. Yeah. Real, he was massive. There was, I don't know how many points he had, but he's got mass. The other one looked like a younger deer, small, short tines. Down here hunting with Sean, man. First morning for me. Y'all been down here several days. I got here late last night, and you put me on one. Oh, man, what a buck. It's just something about hunting down there in these palmettos, man.
They're rutting.
And they rutting. That's what people are going to be like, rutting. I'm telling you, February the 6th, and the rut is on, but here it is, Valentine's. They in love. That's all I can tell you. Love got that one whacked. Hey, come on in, ceasefire caller.
What you shoot, man?
Man, are we shooting does?
That's a lie. I don't want to shoot a doe. I mean, you just pulled a celebrity hunt.
A celebrity hunt?
Yeah, you got in last night and getting a stand for 30 minutes and shoot.
Man, I can't help. I got here late last night. I've been in the office doing work, man.
All right, see you.
Last buck of the season. Man, what a good one to go out on. Big old gnarly South Louisiana palmetto buck. I can't believe they're rutting. Here it is, February the 6th. Look at that.
Congratulations.
Louisiana, South Louisiana, way to end the season, man. Goodness. Thank you, buddy. Big old brute.
Got him.
Buck down, buck down.
Big buck down.
When they come trotting out, all I can see was two bucks running, and they racks, both of them had nice racks.
And I said, the first one's bigger. The closer one was bigger. I zoomed to the closer one, and he's sitting there looking around. He goes, you on that buck? I said, yeah, the close one, yeah. One all the mass, I could see them. I was on the right.
Yeah.
How about that celebrity hunt Meacham had? Steak last night and then a 30-minute hunt this morning?
That's what he wrote.
Man, I'm going to start scheduling all my hunts just like this one. Go in at 8, eat a big, 20-pound ribeye and some baked beans with some hamburger in it, and get a good night's sleep and go out the next morning at 8
o'clock. Wake up by daylight and run on out there and blast one.
I mean, that's a nice spot, huh? Ain't nothing wrong with that.
That was cool, man.
Kind of like crappie fishing. When you get a hot spot, drop all the G's. Put all your corks in there, Chad. You know what they call them corks? That's strike indicator.
Let's go get some bread.
This segment of Truth About Hunting was brought to you by Ammo2Go and CSpire. Closed captioning provided by Primo's Final Approach.
Watch the wind trackers. This big buck is straight downwind of the hunter. That typically means the buck is gone, but not with Ozonics. Ozonics is the in-the-field ozone generator. It blankets your scent zone with scent-destroying ozone, so deer won't smell you. This is amazing. The wind tracker almost hits the deer in the nose. Ozonics works, and it's guaranteed. Learn more at ozonicshunting.com.
If I was a steel worker, I'd use Squincher, because staying hydrated means staying productive.
If I work construction, I drink Squincher, because it has more potassium and half the sodium.
If I was a firefighter, I'd drink Squincher, because it's formulated to drink every day.
If I worked the rail, I'd drink Squincher.
Because of the taste.
But we're all hunters, and we drink Squincher, because it's what America's workers drink. Squincher, hydration that works.
There's no mistaking the sights and sounds of a central Louisiana swamp early in the morning. Jordan is behind the camera for Spencer's last morning hunt. And even though this is early February, the rut is on.
Later part of the season, they get a lot of rain, so all the sloughs and flats and stuff are full of water. Bucks like to get up in there and chase does around. Right when we got in our stand, we saw a couple does this morning. So yesterday afternoon, I could hear some deer running around up in here. So we'll sit here and see if we can get one.
Jordan and Spencer have just gotten in the stand when they immediately see deer skirting the edge of the swamp. Spencer is correct. These are horns coming through the palmettos behind these does that are busting out of the thicket right through the water.
Meh.
See?
I think we got him, baby.
Good dog, dude.
Man, I'm afraid.
We're just sitting here now.
I was actually on my phone looking at emails.
You can hear the deer crossing the slough down.
Man, that water just...
Man, it is middle of February.
70 degrees? What?
And they it's like they're full rut.
What is it? February, what, 7? Yeah, 6 or 7, something
like something
that.
Something like hey, we might have to get a boat to come in here.
I'm telling you.
It all paid off.
It all paid off, I'm telling you. Don't ever give up.
That's that all I got to say.
Beautiful deer, man.
Hey, I literally been hunting since October 1st. And it seems like every weekend I can't catch the weather right or something.
Well, you didn't catch it right today either.
And it's just, I mean, we got that extended season this year. And them deer are rutting right now, and it's the 6th or 7th, I can't even remember, of February. Mardi Gras this weekend. It's crazy.
Yep. Congratulations, Spencer.
Thank you, Jordan.
Thanks for being with us on The Truth and sharing with us what we love and cherish so much, this great sport of hunting. Join us again as we continue the tradition of hunting and just living the outdoor lifestyle. God willing, we'll see you next week.